The Zionist ideology was born out of the ultranationalism and anti-Semitism of the 19th and 20th century. Its basic principle is the desire for a national Jewish homeland in the predominantly Muslim land of Palestine. Zionists justify this demand by pointing to their history of plight as well as their expulsion from Palestine some two millennia ago as a justification for the establishment of a Jewish state. Theodor Herzl is considered the father of Zionism, and his book, entitled The Jewish State, became influential amongst the Zionists. When World War I broke out, the declining Ottoman Empire joined the Central Powers against the Triple Entente. The reason for Ottoman intervention is because of a historical power struggle between Russia and the Caliphate over the Balkans and the Turkish Straits. With increasing global polarization, war seemed inevitable. Therefore, the Ottomans joined the Central Powers in the hope of retaining its already crumbling empire. The consequences of participation for the Ottomans would be devastating. The only real victory the Ottomans attained in World War I was its successful defense of Gallipoli. The rest of the war was a disaster for the once great empire. The triumphant British and French imposed their hegemony over the sick man of Europe even before the end of the war. They adopted duplicitous and deceptive policies by using certain groups in the region to further their imperial interests at the expense of the locals. In 1915, the British manipulated the Arabs of the Hejaz and managed to use them against the Ottomans. That same year, T.E. Lawrence was sent as an advisor for the Arab tribes. In the Hussein-McMahon Accords, the British offered the Arabs a caliphate stretching from the Arabian Peninsula to Iraq, but were vague on the issue of Palestine. It was assumed that Palestine would be handed to the Arabs. The Arabs convincingly accepted the deal and began their revolt against the Ottoman Empire. In 1916, the British and French established what was to be one of the most significant contemporary disasters for the Middle East, the Sykes-Picot Agreement. This agreement assumed that the Allies would be victorious over the Central Powers, and therefore the Ottoman Empire would have to be split amongst the victors. France demanded the regions of Syria and Lebanon, while British took Iraq and Transjordan. Palestine was agreed on to be an international zone. The Imperial Powers imposed new borders, reflecting their imperial interests while totally disregarding the diversity of the region, something that the Ottomans had managed successfully. Iraq was formed out of three distinct provinces, while Syria was split into multiple zones based on sectarian and religious lines. The agreement contradicted the Hussein-McMahon Accords that promised the Arabs Syria and Iraq, while never explicitly stating that Palestine would be an international zone. It would have a lasting impact on the Middle East.
ISIL believes the geographical boundaries of the Middle East need to be redrawn. Those borders were created in the aftermath of the First World War, after the fall of the Ottoman Empire.
It had stretched from the shores of the Bosphorus to the Red Sea, and from the Caucasus Mountains to the Gulf. But Ottoman defeat in World War I saw the victorious Western allies break up the empire. In a series of treaties, many of the modern-day Arab states were created. Often, frontiers were drawn arbitrarily. Europeans used straight lines on maps to demarcate areas, often with no ethnic or tribal considerations. And some modern analysts believe decisions by the French and British then created the conditions for the battles of today.
On the 2nd of November 1917, the British took another evasive policy move as they now promised Palestine to the Jews. This agreement is known as the Balfour Declaration. The agreement contradicted the Hussein-McMahon Accords, as the British now promised Palestine to both the Arabs and the Jews. It also violated the Sykes-Picot Agreement with the French, as granting Palestine to the Jews rendered the notion of an international zone redundant. There are a number of reasons why the British decided to take this move. Firstly, the Russian Revolution had just occurred, and the oppressive Tsarist regime had been overthrown largely by Jewish efforts. It was believed that the Jews also possessed power within the U.S. government. Meanwhile, the Western Front became a stalemate. Under these conditions, the British estimated that if Palestine was handed over to the Jews, something of historical and religious importance, then America would join the war from the influence of the Zionist lobby. Soon enough, America did join the war, and the stalemate was crushed. A second reason for the British decision to grant Palestine to the Jews was due to war debt. Chaim Weizmann was responsible for producing acetone, which was used in bombs. Acetone was in very high demand due to the war. However, the British struggled to pay for the bomb materials and instead came to the agreement with Weizmann of repaying the debt by granting Palestine to the Zionists. A third reason was because of British imperial tensions with France, as stated by historian James Barr. Granting Palestine to the Jews would create an ally in the region that would act as a buffer between French-controlled Syria and the vital Suez Canal, a region of great tension between the British and French. The Treaty of Sèvres essentially ratified the somewhat modified Sykes-Picot Agreement. Various parts of the Middle East were divided into League of Nations mandates between the British and the French. These include the French mandates of Syria and Lebanon, as well as the British mandates of Iraq, Transjordan, and Palestine. Most of the non-mandates remained as colonial possessions. Throughout the 1930s and 40s, Jews began to emigrate to Palestine in their masses. Zionist state building was greatly facilitated by Jewish administrative experience as well as British support. The Jewish land grabs and ubiquitous settlements eventually caused the 1936 Arab Revolt. It was brutally put down by the British. The British were looking for a solution to the problems in Palestine, and in 1937, under the Peel Commission, they concluded that a two-state solution was the only appropriate option. In 1939, they published the White Paper that identified the Jews as mainly responsible for causing internal chaos. As a result, Jewish emigration was reduced. This controversial policy further exacerbated Jewish terrorism. In 1946, the King David Hotel was bombed in retaliation. The Second World War revealed the barbarity of the Holocaust that wiped out a significant number of the Jewish population. In addition, the war significantly weakened Britain, which could no longer afford to sustain its empire. On the 29th of November, 1947, UN Resolution 181 was passed with a vote of 33-13 in favor of a partition of Palestine. On the 14th of May, 1948, the British left Palestine and the Zionists declared the creation of a Jewish state. What followed was the Great Nakba, numerous wars, and tensions that exist till this day. For more content like this, please like the video, subscribe to Global Frontier, and donate if possible.